Welcome to this instructional video for the SKF Fixed Size Induction Heater EAZ series. This video will show you how to set up and use the EAZ. The SKF Fixed Size Induction Heater EAZ series can be used for the mounting and dismounting of cylindrical roller bearings. Additionally, it can be used with roll groove rings of cold reducing machines or roll body side labyrinth rings of bearing arrangements. Each EAZ heater is intended for one particular size of component only. To select the correct heater, go to skf.com. In the Heater Selection tool, click on CRB Applications and enter your bearing designation. This will populate the inner and outer ring measurements for your application. Next, select your main supply voltage and frequency. And click on Search to identify the correct heater. Before using the EAZ heater, spend some time reading the instruction manual provided with the heater. And be aware that people wearing pacemakers or implants must keep at least 5 meters from the induction heater during operation. Avoid contact with hot surfaces. Electronic equipment may be affected. There is danger of harming your hands. Always use heat-resistant gloves and read the instructions. EAZ heaters are used with a control cabinet which supplies the right current and voltage to the EAZ coil. This control cabinet must be ordered separately. In this example, the transformer is set to 400 volt input. You can correct the exact level by connecting the other pins for plus or minus 15 volts. Using a qualified electrician, connect the EAZ coil to the cabinet. First, connect the earth wire. Then connect phase 1 and phase 2. Now connect the cabinet to the mains. Connect the ground, then connect 2 phases out of the 3 available. Check all connections. Then the cabinet can be closed and locked. Now earth the shaft by connecting the grounding cable to the control cabinet box. Then connect the magnetic clamp to the shaft. Connect the control cable to the box and then the temperature probe extension cable to the cabinet. Now connect the control cable to the heater. Finally, connect the temperature probe cable to the extension and place the probe on the heater. In the case of a 2 outputs cabinets, the process is the same. The difference here is that there are 2 different EAZ coils which are to be connected separately, as in the picture shown here. Now we can start to use the EAZ. First, place the EAZ heater over the inner ring of the bearing that you want to dismount. If a crane or hoist is used, use fabric ropes only. Position the withdrawal plates in the recess behind the inner ring. Then, tighten the locking screws. If no recess is present, then use a crowbar to displace the inner ring after heating. Then, apply the withdrawal plates. Now position the temperature probe to measure the inner ring temperature, or use a thermometer. On the first time using the heating time and temperature have to be determined. Press the dismount icon, then set the desired temperature, and push start to initiate the dismounting process. Once the temperature is reached, the heater will automatically demagnetize the bearing and stop. Do not forget to use heat-resistant gloves. The cabinet will then make an audible signal indicating that the bearing ring can now be withdrawn. Without delay, dismount the bearing inner ring. First, remove the temperature probe and then remove the EAZ coil with the bearing ring inside. Loosen the withdrawal plates and, to avoid possible damage to the EAZ heater, remove the heated bearing inner ring as quickly as possible. The bearing inner ring has now been successfully dismounted. For subsequent dismounting, use the same time and temperature settings. To mount a ring to the shaft, place the bearing inner ring inside the EAZ coil. Select mounting mode on the control panel. Then set the time or temperature and press start. Make sure you are wearing suitable heat-resistant gloves. When the heating is completed, the control cabinet will make an audible noise. Then remove the bearing ring from the inside of the EAZ coil as quick as possible and mount the bearing ring onto the shaft. For safety, if the EAZ coil is getting too hot or the temperature control cable inside of the EAZ coil is not connected, the heating will be interrupted and an overheating sign will be displayed. When the temperature probe is not connected or damaged, an error E06 will be shown. Make sure that the probe is properly connected and that the probe is not damaged. Only in the case of emergency, you can switch off the cabinet by using the emergency stop button on the EAZ coil. The control cabinet is also equipped with a circuit breaker switch. For more information, go to skf.com or contact your local authorised SKF distributor.